Are you struggling to see the right data that you need inside of your SmartSuite apps or solutions? Well, if so, you don't want to miss this video because we're going to be going into detail about a specific view type, the dashboard view in SmartSuite, that will allow you to put together all kinds of different widgets to enhance the way that you look at your data inside of your solutions. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Hey, welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I own Gap Consulting, and we make it our mission to help you get organized and automated with no-code tools. SmartSuite, obviously, is at the forefront of no-code tools, and we are excited to be talking about dashboards in this particular video. We're going to be going into all the things that make up a dashboard and how you can add new things, new widgets to your dashboard so that you can see exactly what you need from your data. But before we get into it, let me first invite you to check out our SmartSuite affiliate link below. This is a great way for you to follow along. If you are not already a SmartSuite user, go ahead and sign up using that link, and it's going to show some love back to the channel. But also, if you upgrade to a paid plan, you are eligible for some exclusive SmartSuite swag. So do use that link. If you don't use the link, you're not eligible for that promo. So let's go ahead now and hop on into my screen and just kind of set the tone for what we're doing. Here I am inside of a solution called inventory tracking. And in here we see we've got a bunch of different applications, and I'm on the sales order application. Now on this particular application, we've linked to a product here. We also have a date of the order, and we have the platform, so whether it was online or in store, we have a quantity, and then we have a little formula that's able to calculate the revenue generated from this sale. It's actually looking in and figuring out what the price of this particular unit is. So here in winter coat, we see the price of $399 right here, and it's taking that number, multiplying it by the quantity, therefore generating the revenue for this particular order. So then how could we put together some dashboards that help us understand this data in better ways? Well, the first thing to understand is that a dashboard is simply a view inside of your application. So we'll go into the upper left-hand corner here to access our views, and we will just create a new view from the list. Now, over here, you'll see that each view has its own icon type. So the one that we're currently using is a grid view, and you can see that demonstrated right here by the little grid view icon. But when we're over here creating a new view, what we will look for here is the dashboard. And so the icon we're looking for is that teal color with a few different shapes involved. Now, as I hover over here, you can see that it says that the dashboard uses interactive widgets to track key metrics and embed rich content into one powerful view. So let's go ahead and implement the dashboard view type. Of course, name your dashboard whatever you'd like. Determine if it's going to be public or private, and then go ahead and create that view. Now it takes just a moment to get set up here. The first thing we need to do is add a widget. And we have two different places we can go, either add the widget down here at the bottom of the screen or in the upper right corner, we have the add widget option here as well. Either one you choose is gonna get you the same result. What we're trying to do here is add an element to this dashboard. So let's go ahead and use this button on the bottom here and go ahead and add a widget. Now, as soon as we make that selection, you're gonna see all the different types of widgets that are possible to add into your SmartSuite dashboard. So over here on the left-hand side, we can navigate all the different types of widgets that we have. Obviously, we're looking at all from the beginning. We can drill down to metrics, charts, conferencing, design, Google, etc. So I'll let you explore all these different widgets in your own time, but essentially what we want to do here, because we're playing in our example with some sales data, is we want to look at some charts and see how we can slice and dice that information. So let's go ahead and add a column chart to start here. And once we insert this widget, what we're going to see is just kind of the default settings that are going to take place when we first make that selection. But we haven't technically added the widget just yet. Now, our next step is to come into the widget settings and make sure that we've established this particular widget to show us what we want to see. So for example, maybe we want to look at our revenue on a bar graph bucketed by month because we have the date information as well as the revenue information in our sales orders application. So first and foremost, Here's our first option. What type of chart are we looking at? We already picked the column chart, but of course we can make some selection changes if we would like to. If we picked the wrong thing, or if we want to change this over time, maybe we want to look at stacked area or stacked column, whatever. You get a lot of different options in terms of the type of chart we're looking at. Next on down, we're going to look at the solution level. So of course, for us, we are in our inventory tracking solution. And whenever we build a dashboard, it's going to reflect data that lives in a solution and presumably in one or more apps. And so for this particular widget, we're looking at the inventory tracking solution, and then of course our sales order application. So just to note here, we started building this particular dashboard from our sales order app, which is why it's preloaded here. But we could turn this around and look at a different application in this solution if we so choose. Now, we also get to determine what are we looking at. So in terms of values, right now it's set to count the auto number field, which doesn't really tell us a lot of anything. But here, if we click on this particular value, we can scroll on down and look at the different fields that we have access to inside of whatever application we've selected. So for us, we're in our sales order app, and we can drill on down to that revenue field and get an idea of what's happening here. Now, once we've made that selection, you'll see that we also can then choose what we want to do with that revenue. So do we want to look at the minimum value, thereby looking at all the different records in this app and choosing the smallest value, or maybe the max value, or maybe the average value, or in our case, the sum. Of course, we want to sum up all of the different records that we find inside of our sales order application, and specifically sum the revenue of all those different orders. Now, this is perfectly set up and I love this, but we can still get a little bit more granular if we'd like by adding a filter. Now, coming into the filters here, we can apply some rules and say, hey, exclude some information if it doesn't meet these conditions, or include only information that meets these conditions. For example, we might say that I only want to look at revenue data that came after a specific date. So we could actually come in, find that date and say, well, I only want to look at any data that comes after in the past month, for example. So in this way, we would then only be filtering in that exclusive information. And as you see, we don't have any information on our chart because all of our revenue data is historic and far in the past. So let's go ahead and exclude our filter here, but just know that you can apply a filter to your charts and graphs inside of your dashboard as well. Now, moving on here, I can decide to group. And for our example, I said, I want to group this by the date. So I want to group by the month specifically. So I select the date field here, and then I can choose, well, what do I want to look at in terms of date? Do I literally want to see date over date over date, which is what's showing right here? Or do I want to bucket these dates, maybe by week, and thereby consolidating that information into weekly buckets? Or, as I said, in our case, I want to see stuff by month. So I can make that selection here as well. So there it is. We are all set up now in this. But before moving on, let's take a look at just a couple more options here. I can add a total to the chart. So in this example, I might say I want to actually include the total number of quantities sold, or maybe the total amount of revenue over all the months. And so I could make that selection here. And what we see is that up in the upper left corner here, we're getting that total here. Now, bear in mind that this total is the total for everything across this entire graph. And so here I might have $1,467 worth of revenue. And over here in November, I have 90. This total is showing me the sum for everything on the graph. I also have the ability to put in a benchmark line. So if we have sales goals, for example, I can add a benchmark line and come in and say, sales target. And I'll just go ahead and type that in here and assign a number to that. Maybe it's $1,000 per month. Once I assign that, you see that we get this nice little line coming in showing us that we exceeded our target for the month of October and we failed to hit it in the month of November. So my point here is that there is a lot that you can do with these charts and graphs and different ways that you can visualize this data inside of your SmartSuite dashboard. Now, once I'm happy with this, I can go ahead and add this widget. But this is only the beginning of the dashboard because I can then resize all of these elements here and play with them by moving them around on my screen wherever I want them inside of my dashboard. Now, one thing of important note is that any information that people are excluded from seeing because of permissions inside of your SmartSuite application, well, that permission level will carry on down into your dashboards. So if you have taken away the ability for people to see revenue numbers, then they won't be able to see the revenue graph that is generated by data that comes from those revenue numbers. So it's important to remember that permissions will carry all the way through your solutions inside of SmartSuite. So make sure that when you're sharing your dashboards, that you've given people permission to see the stuff that you want them to see. Now, we can, of course, from here, add additional widgets simply by clicking on the widgets here. And there are many, many different ones you can include. Things like conferencing from Google Meet and Zoom, bringing in design elements in Vision Widget and also Figma. Also going into Google, so applying some Google Docs, Google Sheets, Google Slides. All kinds of different opportunities for you here inside of your dashboards. The point is that you can include information so that you get everything that you need to see all in one place, consolidated specifically for you. Now, one last thing to note here is that you can add views inside of views. So for example, if you had a grid view inside of SmartSuite that you wanted to bring in and include here on your dashboard, you can do that simply by making that selection here. Say the view type of grid view, tell it what solution again, what apps, and then also what display options you want here. So you can allow people to edit the data directly inside of this dashboard view. And of course, it's view within a view here. We've got the grid view inside of the dashboard, and we're able to edit all that data right there. Let's actually go ahead and plug this particular dashboard view in, and I'm going to then add some more information here right into our sales data. Let's suppose that I sold something here. I'll call this number 11 and move on over here to say the quantity of things were 4. And of course, I'm going to need to find what product that is. So I'll bring Slim Jeans in here. And as I'm making these changes, you're going to see that data reflected on the graph right here. So if I made this sale back in November, once I am done and I save that, now of course we see that new information popping up here, November 2022. Of course, if I made this back in 2021, let's go ahead and scroll all the way back in, then I would not have created a new month here. And I'm again looking at historical data and I'm just bolstering those numbers. So there you have it. You're able to edit things right then and there, and everything is going to be automatically updated because these widgets are using the same data in order to give their different outputs. I know we went fast in this video, but this is just the tip of the iceberg in terms of implementing dashboards in your SmartSuite solutions. So I encourage you to just try it out for yourself and let me know in the comments below this video what you love about it and if there are things that you'd like to see updated or changed. That's it for this one. If you haven't already, please consider subscribing so you don't miss out on future no-code videos just like this. And I will see you in the next video.